Today's video is sponsored by kiiiiiinda. It is the first chef-to-consumer platform delivering freshly prepared, pre-selected meals right to your door weekly. kiiiiiinda connects a diverse group of talented chefs that cook delicious, inventive meals fresh every day in regional micro-kitchens, not warehouse production facilities. Because we are renovating our kitchen on our own, it's taking a very long time, and there's a lot of setbacks because we have an older home, so cooking has been a challenge. Oftentimes, I don't even have a working kitchen, but I still want to eat balanced meals, which is why it's so nice that the meals are delivered fully cooked, so all you have to do is heat them up. No more cleanup and meal planning. And chefs cook meals with real ingredients, nothing artificial, with humanely raised meat and organic ingredients when possible. For tonight's dinner, I chose La Mama's Meatloaf, made by Lamar Davidson at the Atlanta, Georgia location. Spoiler alert, it was absolutely delicious. I loved it so much. It really did feel like homemade meatloaf. There is a wide range of meals with over 7 different dietary preference filters, including vegan, paleo, and gluten-free options. The chefs focus on flavor and inventiveness, while leaning into a wide range of different types of cuisines to bring you the best meals possible. Through a weekly subscription, you can select from a robust, ever-changing menu of handcrafted meals. The subscription is super flexible, and you can pause, skip weeks, or cancel at any time. I love kiiiiiinda. It really fits my lifestyle. I love that I can get quick and easy meals that are delicious. It's a fit for me. So if you want to give it a try for yourself, you can get 50% off your first order of kiiiiiinda meals by going to kiiiiiiinda.com and using my code AmyK50 at checkout. Okay, AmyK50. Thank you so much to kiiiiiinda for sponsoring this video, and let's get on. I'm sorry to keep you here like this, but you aren't supposed to be here, are you? I hope you're at least comfortable where we have you. Yes, right. I can't let you go. I'm sorry. Let me introduce myself. I'm Dr. Christine Palmer, and I work at the Baxter Institute doing multiversal research. You know about the multiverse, don't you? Perhaps because this isn't your universe? Right? Well, we know it's not your universe. In fact, let's take a look. It says here that you, says here that you are from Earth 616, and Earth 627. That's not right. That doesn't make sense. Should be only one. Looks to be 616, but it keeps glitching. Either way, this is not your universe. And I'm sorry, but I need to check you for quantum viruses and other things, like the bigger impacts, like universal pressures or potential incursions. Have you not heard of incursions? You haven't come across any universes that seem to be falling into themselves? How long have you been? Okay. Well, if you didn't know, the bigger your impact in each individual universe, the longer you're here, the bigger the chances of the universes colliding. One might eat the other. They might end up destroying each other. And that's not something that we want to happen here. Here at the Illuminati. So, I'm going to check you for viruses, and then I'm going to send you home. Okay? Let's get a look. So we've already done a couple tests.
Did they already take a blood sample?
You haven't done a blood sample yet?
Right.
Okay, I'm just gonna go check that. Are you sure we haven't done a blood sample? I could have sworn that we did. How many universes have you been to? You're not sure. Okay. Let me ask my assistant. Did she take blood? Not yet. Sorry. I just thought I heard something. Okay, well then, I'm going to do that really quickly, if that's okay. It'll be really quick, okay? Going to be okay? You can handle this? Alright. If you feel woozy at all, please let me know. I'm just gonna wipe the area here. Hold out your arm, please. Okay. I'm going to tie up your arm here so we can get a better vein. Okay, that isn't too tight. Alright. Okay, hold still. You can look away if you're not very good with needles, alright? Still. 3, 2, 1. Okay. Alright. That wasn't so hard. Okay. Can you clench your fist for me, please? Good. Place this over here. Alright. Just going to take some of this and can you hold that there for me? Just hold that there on your arm. Wasn't too hard, was it? example, just let the doctors out. That just can't be right. That's not right. Okay. Let's get going on some other samples so I can check to make sure that you don't have any quantum viruses. Okay. I'm just going to take a close look at your face. Eyes really quickly, okay? Okay. Good. Keep your eyes open, please. Look at your other eye. Open, 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 please. Okay. Okay. Gonna gather a few samples, okay? So first I'm going to another sample. Still, I'm just going to get a skin sample. This potential lesion here. Okay. Good. Okay, and I want to get a skin. Seeing any parts of your skin that look like there could be potential multiversal lesions popping up. There's nothing obvious, so I have to go by how your skin looks right now. So I'm just going to then in here. Thank you. going to hook this up. Just to see if I can get any reading. To be honest, I haven't seen this before. There are many times that we get a multiversal being in our universe, so being able to research you is an amazing opportunity for me, but it's also scary. Have you tried to reach out to anyone you know in this universe? From your old universe? A different version of friends, maybe? Is there someone in this universe that you've brought with you from 616 or 137? If so, we really need to know about this. Because your mind could shatter, get stuck in a different universe at the same time, co-conscious. I see. I'm trying to help you. I sense that holding some information from me, and I just want you to know that I'm here for you. I'm protecting my universe and yours, so if there's anything you need to tell me, please let me know. to you, but to a trained eye, it is potentially something. Hold still. Get another sample, okay? Saliva sample. Just to check for more viruses or diseases that you could have. Or that you could have caught in a different universe. Could potentially explain what's going on here. Thank you. Here's a sample. Okay. Just want to get... I'm going to take a look at your scalp. Just look at your scalp. There's any deformations in the scalp. Because we don't want to hear anything. To see if there's any impacts from traveling in the multiverse. And just, of course, take a check to make sure that we don't see your scalp. Seems to be just fine. There doesn't seem there's any potential more time. Check behind your head. It's not too bad. Okay. So let's put all of this in the system. See if we can find something. Just a reason. Just a meaning. Seen you change at all. Everything's stuck. Just write down what it is you're wearing just in case. Just in case it changes. Go look over my research and then look over what our findings were today. Again, I'm sorry for keeping you, but I can't have you risking an incursion, so I will speak to you soon when I find the results. Okay. And if I don't see you.